have sarcolemma dipping down from the T-tubule, but only one sarcoplasmic reticulum on the side. This is known as D-diade. Diade is for two, while triade was for three. One T-tubule with two sarcoplasmic reticulum, that was T-triade. One T-tubule with one sarcoplasmic reticulum, this is diade. Diade is a feature of your cardiac tissue. Diade is present at the level of Z9. It helps in the contraction of the muscle, and same contractility mechanism is present in your cardiac tissue as was present in your skeletal muscle. Innervation of the cardiac tissue is by autonomic nerves, sympathetic and parasympathetic. Sympathetic is going to increase the contraction, parasympathetic is going to lower the contraction of the cardiac tissue. Apart from the cardiac tissue, from the heart, cardiac tissue is also seen in the vessels that are entering and exiting the heart, the superior vena cava, inferior vena cava, and the pulmonary veins. They also have the cardiac tissue. So these are the slides showing the diade system present in the heart, the sarcolemma dipping down to forming the T-tubule with the sarcoplasmic reticulum on one side. Slide showing heart as an organ. Organ composed of tissue, the myocardial tissue. Myocardial tissue composed of cardiac cells known as cardiac myocytes. Each cardiac myocyte, when seen under the light microscopic, has dark and light bands, actin and myosin filaments. Same structure of sarcomere is seen here, with the A band, I band, M line, Z line, H zone. And we just did that D-diade is present in the cardiac muscles, and the D-diade is present at the level of your Z-line. And other significance of the Z-line is that it is going to at this Z-line you are going to see a zigzag line. Under the light microscopy, you are going to view it as a zigzag line in the cylindrical cardiac myocyte. This zigzag line is the intercalated discs. As where the cardiac myocyte, the cylinders branch, they are connected to the other cardiac myocyte. And when where they connect, there is a connection. This is called intercalated disc, the Z-zag, seesaw, serrated disc-like structure. And when you see it under the electron microscopy, this intercalated disc, it is a specialized feature. It has got cell junctions which connect one cardiac myocyte with the other one. The neighboring cardiac myocytes are connected to one another. And what is the need for this connection? The need for this connection is that the electric impulse to pass and the cardiac unit to push and pump as one single unit. And when you view it under electron microscope, you see that there are transverse junctions as well as a longitudinal junction. In fact, there are three junctions connecting the one cardiac myocyte to the other. In the longitudinal junction, you have a gap junction known as nexus, which allow the passage of ions, calcium and sodium from one cell to another, helping in the contraction. And in the transverse junctions, you see fascia adherents, which bind the actin filaments, and the macula adherents, also known as desmosome, which are going to bind and link the intermediate filaments of the cardiac myocyte. These are the slides showing the intercalated disc, the zigzag disc, and how does it look under electron microscopy. You see the cardiac myocyte, the rich in mitochondria as well. T-tubule can be seen, diade at the level of Z-line, and at the level of Z-line also the presence of intercalated disc. Two features at Z-line, you must remember that. Acha ji, we are done with the cardiac muscle cells. Specialized cardiac muscle cells are also seen in the subendocardial region. In the myocardium, you are going to study, when you are going to study heart as an organ, that it has epicardium, myocardium and endocardium. In the subendocardial region, there are specialized muscle fibers. Myocardium is composed of these muscles which we have studied. In the subendocardial region, there are specialized muscles, muscle fibers or cardiac myocytes. They are larger in diameter than the usual cardiac myocyte, and they stain lighter than the cardiac myocyte. What is the reason for being light staining? They are the pacemaker of the heart. They are known as Purkinje fibers, and they are loaded with glycogen. As they have to initiate the nerve impulse and the cardiac rhythm, they need more energy. So they are loaded with glycogen, and these glycogen wash up during staining and giving it a pale appearance. These are the slides showing the normal cardiac myocytes, the branching pattern, intercalated disc, while Purkinje fibers, which are larger in diameter, pale staining. Achha. In relation to the clinical applied anatomy of the cardiac myocytes, we are concerned, can cardiac myocyte undergo hypertrophy and hyperplasia? Can it regenerate? Yes, cardiac myocytes can undergo hypertrophy, but not hyperplasia. Hypertrophy is a feature of cardiac myocyte. It increases in size. Hypertrophy is the increase in the size. Cardiac myocytes, when there is increased workload, for example, in the athletes, the cardiac myocyte increases their size, increases in their diameter. This is known as cardiac hypertrophy. And in diseases where there is prolonged workload, the cardiac tissue undergoes cardiac hypertrophy. This is known as hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. It is a pathological phenomenon when there is an increased burden on the heart. Hyperplasia is not seen in the heart. Regeneration capacity. If there is a decrease in the blood flow, or if the blood flow is blocked to the heart, the heart and the tissue and the cells are going to die, of course. And can they regenerate? We saw that in skeletal muscle, there was some regeneration capacity due to the satellite cells that were present there. But satellite cells are not seen in cardiac cells, cardiac myocytes. So cardiac myocyte, when the cell is injured, it cannot regenerate. The fibroblasts take up the place. They increase the collagen level there and form a scar over there. This impedes the functioning of the heart. Some views are that the pericytes in the blood vessels, they can cover up and regenerate, but it is under the this is under your research is going on this topic. So in your books, it is written the cardiac myocyte cannot regenerate once they are damaged. This is going to lead to cardiac fibrosis, fibrotic tissue, and scarring there. What is myocardial infarction? Myocardial infarction is when the blood or oxygen level to the cardiac myocyte is compromised. When there is a blockage of the major vessels to the heart, there is decrease in the oxygen level, decrease in the blood flow, and the cardiac myocyte is going to get necrosed and die off. This is known as myocardial infarction. Now we are going to